Hey guys, what's up? I'm Brett, and today on Math Hacks, we are tackling some of those more difficult and confusing factoring quadratic problems where the leading coefficient is a number other than one. Factoring quadratics where the leading coefficient is greater than one can be one of those pain points for students, and that's because when you begin to factor this type of quadratic, you quickly realize that there are a whole bunch of options for what you can place in those binomials, and it gets really confusing quickly. The method that you're going to learn today is called the ACB method, or the CAB method for short. And essentially what it does is it takes away all of that guesswork and gives you a nice step-by-step process you can follow every time that you need to factor one of these quadratics. Let's get started. So as I mentioned in our introduction, we are learning how to factor quadratics where the leading coefficient is a number other than 1. And when I say leading coefficient, I'm talking about the coefficient on the x squared term. So in this case, my leading coefficient is 6. Now in general, factoring quadratics where the leading coefficient is a number other than 1 is kind of a tricky task because having that extra number here creates a lot more possibilities on how to factor it. And if you're doing this with guess and check, which maybe you've tried before and realized, wow, that's a lot of combinations and I'm having a hard time figuring out which ones are the correct arrangements. So what we have here today is a nice and easy method that you can follow whenever you need to factor a quadratic where the leading coefficient is a number other than 1. And this method is called the ACB method, also known as the CAB method, and it is a series of steps that you can follow every single time you have a quadratic like this one. And in those steps, the first thing we do is we are going to multiply the a and c values together. Now remember, in quadratics, the a term is the value on the x squared, the b is the coefficient on x, and the c is the constant. So what we want to do to get started is to multiply a and c together. So for this first problem, I'm going to multiply 6 and negative 5 together. So if you have a minus sign here, make sure to take it with you as part of C. When I do that off to the side, I see that 6 times negative 5 equals negative 30. Now I'm going to move on to step 2, which is to find factors of A times C that add to B. So I want factors of negative 30 that add to positive 7. First, I'm just going to list out all the factors I can think of negative 30. It's important to note here that if you have a negative number as your product of a times c, then you want to make sure to list all the possible combinations of that negative value. So notice how I had negative 1 times 30 as well as negative 30 times 1, negative 6 times 5 as well as negative 5 times 6, negative 3 times 10 as well as negative 10 times 3. Now that's important because in the next step I'm going to look for the pair of factors that add to positive 7. I'm just going to skim this list and see which ones work. So the pair that works is negative 3 times 10, because negative 3 plus 10 equals 7. Now that's important because we want our factors that we're going to choose to combine to the middle term. So here, if I attach x's to these, I see that negative 3x plus 10x equals 7x. And 7x is our middle term. So what I'm doing essentially is in the next step, I'm going to replace 7x with negative 3x plus 10x. And I found the negative 3 and 10, remember, from the factors of a times c. In the next step, we are going to copy down the first and last terms. So I'm simply going to go over here, take the 6x squared and the minus 5, and write them on the next line with some space in between. Then in step 4, in between the first and last terms, I'm going to write down the factors we found in step 2 with the x's attached. So that's this guy right here. So remember, this is going to replace 7x. So right in between these, I'm going to write negative 3x plus 10x. And now all we have to do is factor by grouping, which I covered in a previous lesson. So if you need a little bit more help with factor by grouping, check that out. Otherwise, we're just going to group
the first two terms together and the second two terms together and pull out their GCFs. Once I've pulled out the GCFs, I should have matching binomials left over. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to factor out these matching binomials. Again, this is part of the factor by grouping process. When I do that, I get 3x plus 5 left behind as my second binomial. And there we go. We have factored our quadratic into two binomials. Pretty nifty, huh? All right, so on this next problem, we have the quadratic 8x squared plus 10x plus 3. And again, we're going to use the ACB method, the steps outlined here, to factor it into two binomials. I'll start by multiplying the a coefficient and constant together. Now I'll list all the factors of 24. Now notice here, because in our quadratic we have all positive coefficients, I needn't write out any of the negative factors. So that means I don't have to write negative 1 times negative 24, negative 12 times negative 2, negative 6 times negative 4, or negative 3 times negative 8. I automatically know that these are not going to be the correct factors, so I simply just write out the positive ones for this example. Next, I am going to look for the pair of factors that combine to make a positive 10. In doing that, it looks like 6 times 4 is the pair that I want, since 6 plus 4 equals 10. Now remember, what we're really doing is we are going to replace 10x with 6x and 4x. So 6x plus 4x equals 10x. And in the next step, this is going to be our substitution. So instead of 10x, I'm going to write 6x plus 4x. And lastly, we just perform factor by grouping. Now this is really interesting here, because when I factor out the GCF from the first two terms, which is 2x, I get 4x plus 3 left behind in parentheses. As I move on to the second set of two terms, I see that I already have 4x plus 3 here. Remember that when we are factoring by grouping, the stuff left behind in the binomials should be matching. So what do I factor out of this set of two terms so that it matches here? As you may have noticed, the GCF of 4x plus 3 is 1. So we're just going to factor out a positive 1. So I'm going to write plus 1 right here, and then in parentheses, copy down 4x plus 3. That way I ensured that I did factor out something, but I didn't alter the inside. It still matches with the first one. Now we'll factor those guys out. 2x plus 1 times 4x plus 3. For our final example of the day, we are going to factor 6x squared minus 5x minus 6. So once again, I start by multiplying 6 and negative 6 together. I then look for the factors of their product, so the factors of negative 36 that combine to negative 5. First, I'll list off the factors. Once I have all the factors listed, I can go ahead and look for the pair that combines to b. So negative 5 is what I'm looking for. As I scan my list here, I see that negative 9 times 4 adds to negative 5. Of course, we will be substituting negative 5x out with this pair here. So negative 9x plus 4x equals negative 5x. So this will be the substitution for negative 5x in my equation. I'd like to note here that it doesn't matter which order these two terms are in, so long as the signs are correct. So negative is on the 9 and positive is on the 4. My factoring would work just as well if I put 4x minus 9x here. Lastly, I'll do factor by grouping. There we go. we once again have factored 6x squared minus 5x minus 6 into the binomials 2x minus 3 times 3x plus 2.
Thank you so much for watching Math Hacks. This channel depends on viewer support, so if you liked what you've seen and you want more math tutorials coming your way, give this video a big thumbs up and click that subscribe button to join our community. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.